Hey guys, I was at Mind Fair in Sacramento over the weekend, and I was teaching a lot of folks there how to build something similar to this. This is for a project that I've been working on to bring a game called Mirror's Edge into Minecraft. It's a game where you're running around on top of buildings and jumping from building to building and all this kind of fun parkour gameplay kind of stuff. And it's all set in this very futuristic, modern, sleek looking city. So, when I was talking with Cleverlike there, who was running the learning lab, he was brought up the idea of creating a tutorial. And I don't think I want to do that right this second, but I thought that I would just jump in here and show you how quickly it is or it can be to start to put together a building and build something really cool when you've taken some time to prefabricate a lot of these assets. This is all known as modular design. This was a lot of what I was talking about at Mindfair. So I'm not going to speed up this video at all, like I've done with some previous time lapse kind of stuff. I'm just going to do this all right now so you can kind of watch. So let's start a timer like right now. Like, bam, there's the timer. Okay. So, first thing I'm going to do is run in here and grab some what I call wire cubes. And I got to decide where my building is going to go. What side is it going to be on? I think since I've got a lot of stuff over here on this right side of the one that's already made, I'm going to build off to the left. And I'm going to put a little bit of space in between so that people can jump from one to the other. Paste that in. I'm using copy and paste a lot to copy and paste a lot of these big assets all over the place. And I'm just gonna build this up and build this up and build this up until we've got something that generally resembles a building. And it's looking okay so far, right? We've got a nice big stack here, but it's kind of the same height as the other one, and I don't want that. I want this one to be, I think, a little bit bigger. So we'll just raise this up a couple notches. And I'm going to go to fill and replace, hit Q, and select the block of quartz because in my project, the block of quartz is my sort of defining concrete, that white concrete. And while I've got that, we'll go down here, we'll select just the back of the building, go to fill and replace, fill that in. And I think the side of my building here, I'm gonna have some windows on. This little inside part here though, we're gonna fill that up with concrete. Let's go all the way down. And now we got to do the fronts of the building for sure. So we'll go back here and grab my storefronts. And I'm going to do, since the other building is black, this one will make blue. We're going to rotate this into place so that it's exactly where I want it. Bam. Slide this in. Control C. Control V. Slide that in. Perfect. All right, now let's do the rest of the windows here. I think I'm gonna do just blue full. It's gonna be just a nice big full stack of windows. Control C, Control V. We're copying and pasting. There we go. And we'll fix this up here, make it look nicer in just a little bit. And the sides, because I wanted the sides to have some windows as well. Just there. That's all we need. The rest down here we're going to fill in with concrete. And this line right here, we're going to fill in with the windows. And for these, we're using the lapis lazuli block. That's what the blue windows are sort of made of. Let's do the same thing here. And all that's left is just these. Cool. So now we've got a nice stack of windows. And, you know, I like that, but just to give it some more abstractness, some uniqueness, let's go like right into here, and this will just all be concrete. I think that looks pretty good. Now, if that's going to be concrete, then we should definitely put a billboard on it. So let's grab like a yellow tall billboard. And we'll just put that right there. Perfect. Snaps right on into place. Looks pretty good. I like how that is. All right. Everything else on our building is put together. It's looking nice. So let's do the tops. Usually I start with, let's go to my roof assets. I start with the lights. For my projects, I like to be able to have a city looking great during the day and great during the night. So I go through the effort of adding lights where I think lights should go. And the edges of my roof here probably need to have some edges. I use half slabs for this. We'll import those in. Copy and paste. We'll do the sides here. And I'm going to leave that one alone, since we're jumping down from here, right? In fact, I'll delete these on the other side. Kind of give a visual marker that you can jump up and down from this side of the building. And let's see. We'll just grab all from here and duplicate it over on the other side. And if it's not totally perfect, I don't mind, because I'm going to be going in to Minecraft at the end of all this to do some minor editing. All right. Next up, let's grab another billboard. I kind of like putting billboards up at the top. So I'm going to use a yellow billboard, and we'll do the cube. Yeah? No. We'll do the yellow small, just like we did on the other side. And we'll put just a couple of them on this side right over here. Did I do that right? Oh, messed up. I put them on top. We'll look at it from back here so I can get a better angle. There we go. Starting to look pretty cool. Okay, so we need some stuff for people to run around on top of. Back into my roof assets, I've got some cool rooftop platforms. And since they're going to be coming from here and jumping down onto this lower building, why don't we do just like this? Perfect. We're going to kind of create a path for the player to follow. And I'm just copying and pasting these little platforms around. There we go. In fact, let's make this one extra tall. And I think I like it Just kind of like that. That looks pretty cool. Okay. The only other thing I think I might do here is we've got to add in. So some security cameras would be cool. Let's put those over here on the side so they can see the whole building, what's going on. I've got a little rooftop security access. Oh, that one's too big. And we've used it on the other building as well. So instead, we'll just do the roof access small. And we'll put this one. Just like this. And you know what? I'm going to flip it. Well, not like that. We'll mirror it. There we go. Kind of create an interesting little thing here. It probably needs to be a little bit wider. So, that's okay. Alright, now we got something. Okay. Let's throw in some big AC units. We'll put them up here. And we'll put them over here. And we'll just double up on these. There we go. That's looking a little bit better. What else do I have? I've got some solar panels. Do we have room for solar panels? Maybe. I kind of like the designs that I got over here. It's kind of two of them stacked together. So we'll do that. And we'll just toss these into place here. Now we're slowly starting to just create some interesting, environments for us to run around in. Okay, I think that's looking pretty good. I can't think of anything else that I want to do. Just for the sake of this, let's grab the backdrop buildings, which are a fun little asset that I've created. And we're just going to toss these right back here. We'll do two of them. We'll do one. Let's replace this so that it looks right. We'll do one kind of here. Copy it, and I'm going to give it a little rotate, and we'll paste the other one right over here. So these are all buildings that I made previously. So, real fun, real easy. I'm going to delete my copied items over here just a little bit. So you can see we've got a nice looking path, I think. But we've got definitely some finer details that need to get added in, and I'll probably do that in Minecraft itself. So as it stands right now, this is looking good, but it can look better. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to make it look a little bit better. So you can already kind of see we've created this nice little path for the player to run down. So I'm going to go ahead and save this. And when this finishes saving, we're going to hop into Minecraft and do the last couple of details. Okay, guys, we've loaded up our little world here into Minecraft. So it's already looking really nice, just in-game. It always looks a little bit different inside of MC Edit. And let's come in here And we can already start to get an idea for how it's going to feel when we're playing around. We can get a good idea of the perspective. And whoa, there we go. There's that jump. So we've got this nice little path here for people to follow. And this is going to end up being really, really cool. But we want to just define this a little bit better. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my block of quartz, sort of my building block, the slab, maybe some stairs just in case, and the pillar quartz, because I've been using that as sort of a an air vent kind of thing. And we'll grab the orange and yellow wool just in case I decide to use it. So let's pop that over here just a little bit. And, you know, we also need one last bit of wool, the red wool. In Mirror's Edge, they use the color red to indicate anything that you can interact with or where you should be heading. So when I'm doing this, I think just like that. Whoa, it started to fall a little bit. We're going to use that just to indicate this is the direction that you should be going. And we can make that jump pretty easily. So I'm not worried about extending this out over the building. Sometimes you can do stuff like that, make it into a little bit of a platform. But it seems to be working out okay. Now we also want to be able to get back up to that building in some way. So let's see how we can do that. We can maybe do something like this. Will that let us get back up? Yeah. It's a little tricky, but it'll work. There we go. Alright, good enough for a demonstration. Alright, next up is, just like you can see how we've added some sort of colored highlights around the side here, I'm going to do the same on this side, except I'm just going to make a nice big wall. And we're going to do it two blocks high, I think. So we'll just fill this in real fast. There we go. That's looking pretty nice. Now, I told you I used the pillar quartz block because it's got these nice little lines and they're different depending on the direction that they're facing. So I'm going to kind of, just like this. This will give us something that we'll have to jump over, right? And we'll just kind of lock those into place like that. And we'll do one more over here. Whoop. So using MC Edit gets all the heavy lifting out of the way so that we can focus on doing fun stuff like this. And I'm just going to use some basic blocks, the quartz block, fill those up. Not super worried about ultra fine detail, just a little something to jump over. Add a little bit of interest into what we're doing. And, you know, last but not least, I'm going to use some stone here. Ooh, new recipe. And we're just going to block out a little section here. and this probably would have been better to do in MC Edit, but since I'm deciding to do it now, it's faster, I think, just to do it like this than to go open MC Edit again. Why bother? So we're going to get rid of all this here and just add in a little bit of variety in our color palette. And when we're all finished, I think we'll be totally done with how we want this to look. We'll finish this off just like that. Perfect. So, is there anything else we can put in here? Yeah, there probably is some stuff here and there, I'm sure. But for now, I think it's looking pretty darn good. So, I'm going to just unload all of this here. Let's zoom back so we can get a nice little idea of what we've got to work with. So we've got a nice fun little path here for the player to follow to get from one building to another. Over on the side where the street is, we've got the fronts of our buildings with some cool looking billboards. And it all looks good at night as well because it's got lots of lights in it. So just as an example, we'll run around a little bit. I know we can't reach up there, but we can hop over these. Oh, we're not good enough. So this is what makes fun sort of parkour once you start to get good at jumping over a lot of the basic elements. Oh, there we go. And we'll jump down to our second building. And we'll get up here and jump up this way, up to the top. And there you go, guys. That is how you start to put together a really fun and interesting looking parkour map. So I hope you learned a little something. In the future, I might do a full-on tutorial on how to really use MC Edit to do things like this. Without me just quickly jumping through, but we'll stop that clock a second ago, and I'll show you on the screen just how long it took. And that's how long it takes to put together just this one building here, nice and easy, and a little bit of details, and we had some fun, and yeah, there you go. So I'll see you guys later. Take care.